Good morning, good morning, good morning to all of the teachers and students here with us today. Welcome to Read Across America Day 2022. We are so excited to have you here. On today's call, we have Ms. Amy Imamura, who's the Director of Community Relations, Sarah Cash, who holds all of our near dear to our hearts, holds us all together, Mr. Harold Johnson, who's a principal PR representative, along with myself, Raina Plummer. We're going to be hosting this event today. You'll get to meet our special guest a little later. This morning, we're going to begin with our first book of the day. We hope you're excited. It's a day full of learning and fun, and we can't wait to spend it with you. Let's get started with our first book of the day.
Hi kids, my name is Officer Chen. I'm with the Los Angeles Airport Police and I'm a bike officer here at the Los Angeles International Airport. So speaking of airports, today we'll be reading a book by Richard Scarry, Busy, Busy Airports. And we'll go right into it. So welcome to the Busy, Busy Airport. Check in at the counter and let's take a look around. The airport is full of all kinds of busy cars, trucks, and planes. Some planes carry passengers, others carry mail and packages. Each plane has to wait its turn to take off or land. The engines roar and the plane speeds down the runway until it soars into the sky. Are you hungry? You can have a meal in midair. Remember to keep your seatbelt fastened. And high above the clouds, it's always sunny. What goes up must come down. It's time to land. What a great adventure! Isn't flying fun? So maybe one day you'll work at the airport or even pilot a plane. And that concludes Richard Scarry's Busy, Busy Airport.
Wow, Raina, the airport is a busy, busy place. That was such a good story. So exciting. You know what's even more exciting? Pups. We need pups in the airport. So everybody, kids, children, I want you to give a big warm welcome. Everybody give a big warm welcome to Amy Imamura. She's gonna tell us and introduce the pups in a great way. Amy?
Thank you so much, Sarah. Hello, everybody. So we're about to talk about the LAX pups. And if you've participated in one of our events before, you may have got to see them. So who are the pups? Well, the pups are our friends, first and foremost. And let's bring up the images of them at the airport. So on this slide, you can see our pups. They help you and your families when you're traveling. So you might feel a little anxious. You might be a little bit nervous when you're flying, and the pups are walking around. You see them in the red vests, and they make you feel a little bit better. As you're traveling, as you're about to get on that airplane. And so we love our pups. So next time you travel, next time you're at LAX, make sure you say hello to the pups inside the terminals. Now, something else that the pups really like to do is dress up. So we are about to launch a poll. So teachers, we need you to get involved on this. We're gonna post the poll, which is gonna show up on your screen. You might need to move it around so you can see the image of the pup on the screen. And the first one is Mason. I want to introduce you to Mason. Who is Mason dressed up as? So students, help your teachers out. Is he dressed up as Batman? Is he dressed up as Superman or the Hulk? So pay attention to that image. What is he wearing? So you'll see some options. So teachers, if you could go ahead and get the answers from your students and go ahead and respond in the poll. We'll give you a couple of seconds. Batman, Superman, or the Hulk are the options. So teachers, I hope you're able to go ahead and enter that. And this poll, it has all the questions. So if it takes a little bit of time, we just want to make sure you're able to enter that in. What do you say, team? Should we move on to the next one? We'll do 3, 2, 1. All right, we'll go to the next character. Which cool character is Chubbs dressed as? So if you saw the movie Frozen, you might see a familiar character in there. Olaf, Kristoff, or Anna? So which cool character is Chubbs dressed as? So teachers, again, if you could poll your students in your classrooms, get that answer, and then go ahead and select that. And I'll do a quick countdown on that. 3, 2, 1. Okay. And then we'll go to the next one. So for this one, what is Chance dressed as? So pay attention, look really closely at that costume. Is Chance a magician, a clown, or a princess? So again, look closely. Magician, clown, or princess? I'm going to go ahead and again, just count down. 3, 2, 1. All right, and on to Penelope. Now, what is Penelope dressed up as? Which character? Is Penelope a pilot? Or is Penelope an airport fire chief? Or maybe an airport police officer? So again, look closely. Everyone look closely at that picture. Look at that uniform and go ahead and pick which character they're dressed up as. And I'll do another countdown. 3, 2, 1. All right. Now, and we'll go through we'll release the results once we go through all the characters. Now, this is actually one of my favorites. Sergio. Which catty character is Sergio dressed as? Puss in Boots, the Cat in the Hat, or Garfield? So look closely at Sergio. 3, 2, 1, and go ahead and answer. Go ahead and make your selection on that poll question. And then Raina, if you could share the results. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, teachers, for coordinating that with your students. And as you can see, the results are on your screen. And then to remove the poll from your screen, you just hit the red button on the screen and it should disappear. All right. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Amy. I'm gonna go ahead and get started with our next book of the day before we bring up our special guest. This is one of my all-time favorite books of ever. I remember hearing this book as a little girl over and over and over again, and I wanted to be kind of like the characters in this book if I could. So we're gonna bring up our next book, which is The Cat in the Hat. Let me get that rolling.
Hello, boys and girls. My name is Senior Lead Officer Albert Carlos with the Los Angeles Airport Police Department. And today we're going to be reading The Cat in the Hat by Dr. Seuss. The sun did not shine. It was too wet to play. So we sat in the house all that cold, cold, wet day. I sat there with Sally. We sat there, we two. And I said, how I wish we had something to do. Too wet to go out and too cold to play ball. So we sat in the house, we did nothing at all. So all we could do was to sit, 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 sit. And we did not like it, not one little bit. Bump, and then something went bump. How that bump made us jump. We looked, then we saw him step in on the mat. We looked and we saw him, the cat in the hat. And he said to us, "Why do you sit there like that? I know it is wet and the sun is not sunny, but we can have lots of good fun. That is funny. I know some good games we could play," said the cat. "I know some new tricks," said the cat in the hat. "A lot of good tricks. I will show them to you. Your mother will not mind at all if I do." Then Sally and I did not know what to say. Our mother was out of the house for the day. But our fish said, "No, no, make that cat go away. Tell that cat in the hat you do not want to play. He should not be here. He should not be about. He should not be here when your mother is out. Now, now, have no fear. Have no fear," said the cat. "My tricks are not bad," said the cat in the hat. "Why, we can have lots of good fun, if you wish, with the game that I call Up, Up, Up with the Fish." "Put me down," said the fish. "This is no fun at all." "Put me down," said the fish. "I do not wish to fall." "Have no fear," said the cat. "I will not let you fall. I will hold you up high as I stand on a ball, with a book on one hand and a cup on my hat. But that is not all I can do," said the cat. "Look at me. Look at me now," said the cat, "with a cup and a cake on the top of my hat. I can hold up two books. I can hold up the fish and a little toy ship and some milk on a dish. And look, I can hop up and down on the ball. But that is not all. Oh no, that is not all. Look at me, look at me, look at me now. It is fun to have fun, but you have to know how. I can hold up the cup and the milk in the cake. I can hold up these books and the fish on a rake. I can hold the toy ship and a little toy man. And look, with my tail, I can hold the red fan. I can fan with the fan as I hop on the ball. But that is not all. Oh no, that is not all." That is what the cat said. Then he fell on his head. He came down with a bump from up there on the ball. And Sally and I, we saw all the things fall. And our fish came down too. He fell into a pot. He said, "Do I like this? Oh no, I do not. This is not a good game," said our fish as he lit. "No, I do not like it, not one little bit." "Now look what you did," said the fish to the cat. "Now look at this house. Look at this, look at that. You sank our toy ship, sank it deep in the cake. You shook up our house, and you bent our new rake. You should not be here when our mother is not. You get out of this house," said the fish in the pot. "But I like to be here." "Oh, I like it a lot," said the cat in the hat to the fish in the pot. "I will not go away. I do not wish to go." "And so," said the cat in the hat, so, I will show you another good game that I know." And then he ran out. And then, fast as a fox, the cat in the hat came back in with a box. A big red wood box. It was shook with the hook. "Now look at this trick," said the cat. "Take a look." Then he got up on top with the tip of his hat. "I call this game Fun in a Box," said the cat. "In this box are two things. I will show to you now. You will like these two things," said the cat with a bow. "I will pick up the hook. You will see something new. Two things, and I call them thing one and thing two. These things will not bite you. They want to have fun. Then out of the box came thing two and thing one. And they ran to us fast. They said, how do you do? Would you like to shake hands with thing one and thing two? And Sally and I did not know what to do. So we had to shake hands with thing one and thing two. We shook their two hands, but our fish said, no, no, those things should not be in this house. Make them go. They should not be here when your mother is not. Put them out, said the fish in the pot. Have no fear, little fish, said the cat in the hat. These things are good things, and he gave them a pat. They are tame, oh so tame. They have come here to play. They will give you some fun on this wet, wet day. Now, here's a game that they like, said the cat. They like to fly kites, said the cat in the hat. No, not in the house, said the fish in the pot. They should not fly kites. In a house, they should not. Oh, the things they will bump. Oh, the things they will hit. Oh, I do not like it. Not one little bit. Then Sally and I saw them run down the hall. We saw those two things bump their kites on the wall. Bump, thump, thump, bump. Down the wall in the hall. Thing two and thing one. They ran up, they ran down. On the string of one kite, we saw mother's new gown. Her gown with the dots that are pink, white, and red. Then we saw one kite bump on the head of her bed. Then those things ran about with big bumps, jumps, and kicks, and with hops and big thumps and all kinds of bad tricks. And I said, I do not like the way that they play. If mother could see this, oh, what would she say? Then our fish said, look, look. And our fish shook with fear. Your mother is on her way home. Do you hear? Oh, what will she do to us? What will she say? Oh, she will not like it to find us this way. So do something fast, said the fish. Do you hear? I saw her, your mother. Your mother is near. So as fast as you can, think of something to do. You will have to get rid of thing one and thing two. So, as fast as I could, I went after my net. And I said, with my net, I can get them, I bet. I bet with my net, I can get those things yet. Then I let down my net, and it came with a plop. And I had them at last. Those two things had to stop. Then I said to the cat, now you do as I say. You pack up those things, and you take them away. Oh dear, said the cat, you do not like our game. Oh dear, what a shame, what a shame, what a shame. Then he shut up the things in the box with the hook, and the cat went away with a sad kind of look. That is good, said the fish, he has gone away, yes, but your mother will come. She will find this big mess, and this mess is so big and so deep and so tall, we cannot pick it up. There is no way at all. And then, who was back in the house? Why, the cat. Have no fear of this mess, said the cat in the hat. I always pick up all my playthings, and so I will show you another good trick that I know. Then we saw him pick up all the things that were down. He picked up the cake, and the rake, and the gown, and the milk, and the strings, and the books, and the dish, and the fan, and the cup, and the ship, and the fish. And he put them away. Then he said, that is that. And then he was gone with the tip of his hat. Then our mother came in and she said to us too, "Did you have any fun? Tell me, what did you do?" And Sally and I did not know what to say. Should we tell her the things that went on there that day? Should we tell her about it? Now, what should we do? Well, what would you do if your mother asked you? The Cat in the Hat by Dr. Seuss.
That is always one of my favorites. It's so fun. I'm like, I want a thing one and a thing two to play with as well. And now we have a special guest with us here today, the Cat in the Hat in person to play games with us. I'm going to go ahead and bring the Cat in the Hat on up.
Hello, hello, and good morning. A most friendlific welcome to those both tall and small. I hope everyone is doing well. Hello there. Hello, things. Hello, my things. I hope you're ready because up my sleeve, I have great fun for all. Are you ready to play with me today? Yes. Oh, wonderful. I did hope you would say that. Well, here we go. Think of a day that is rainy and gray and as dull as they come. And there is nobody there, and you're kicking a chair, and it's oh, so, oh, nothing to do, and nobody but you on a day that is flatter than flat. And that is a day for the Cat in the Hat. You've got a mind that is one of a kind, so why hide it away? It's time to open the locks and think out of the box, and today is your day. Bounce on the brink of whatever you think, and know what could be better than that. And that is the fun of the Cat in the Hat. The Cat in the Hat. Well, welcome again to all of my friends here with us today. There's so many of us here to play. Oh, but first, before we get into a game or two, today's entertainment is brought to you by the letter. Today's letter. Oh me. Oh my. How will we get by? It seemed to have wandered off. I've lost it. Oh no, what do we do? Well, that's okay. I'll just tell it to you. Today's letter is the letter. Today's letter is. Oh shucks, I can't remember. Well, hey, that's okay. Maybe you can help me. Do you see a letter anywhere by chance? Over there? No, not over there. Oh, over there. No, not there either. Oh, in my hat, I bet. No, nothing there either. Where could it be? Huh? What did you say? A letter you see? Oh, no, not behind me. Up? No, not there either. Oh, I don't. Oh, on top of my hat. Oh, that's a good one. Yes. I think we found our letter right here. Yes, of course, today's letter of the day is the letter D, as in plane. Wait, no. That's not right. That's not right at all. D doesn't begin the word plane. What letter could that be? Do you know? Can you think of it? The letter I'm thinking of begins words like penguin and pineapple and pig, pots, and plates. Without it, places become laces and paints becomes ain'ts. Oh, how about another clue? But once again, it begins with this, the name of this object. What's this one? A plane, that's right. Let's see, so what letter could that be? Puh, 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 puh. Oh, I think I heard it. Yes, oh, what a good thing. The letter P. Oh, you did it. P plus for trying. I mean A plus. Well, let's try this again. Today's entertainment is brought to you by the letter P, as in pilot. And you know, as you might know, pilots are the ones that steer the plane. Can everyone steer our plane with us as we take off? Welcome aboard today's flight. You may just want to hang on tight. Are you ready for takeoff? Oh, I thought maybe so. There's so many places that you and me can go. Flying is exciting, soaring up high like a bird in the sky. But getting from point A to point B can take a little patience and sometimes make you squirmy. Oh, so, it sometimes helps to have other things to do on the journey. So let's up, up, up. Let's get our bodies moving. Relieve some of that boredom. Yes, you two and you three. To make time pass faster, we're going to dance to a beat. Are you ready? Here we go. We're going to explore all the wonderful ways that we can travel. Here we go. Warm up our bodies. We're going to first form the boat. Form the boat. Form the boat. Form the boat. Now sail the boat. Sail the boat. Sail the boat. Sail the boat. Now rock the boat. Rock the boat. Rock the boat. Rock the boat. All right, we're going to get a little bit crazier here. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now rock! Woo! And whoa! That was awesome. What's another way we can travel? Oh, I know. We're gonna form the train. Form the train. Form the train. Form the train. Now toot the train. Toot the train. Toot the train. Toot the train. Now chug the train. 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 Here we go. Full speed ahead. Woo! That was pretty good, but I think it's time to take it up to the sky. Are you ready to fly? We're going to form the chopper. Form the chopper. Form the chopper, form the chopper, and warm up the chopper, warm up the chopper, warm up the chopper, warm up the chopper, and helicopter, 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 helicopter. Woo! Go crazy! Tailspin! Woo! Whoa! Woo! Oh! And last but not least, my personal favorite. Here we go, we're going to form the plane. Form the plane, form the plane, and fly the plane. Fly the plane, fly the plane, fly the plane, and zoom the plane. Zoom the plane, zoom the plane, zoom the plane. Get ready to rock the plane. Here we go. And rock the plane, rock the plane, rock the plane, rock the plane, let's rock the plane, rock the plane, rock the plane, rock the plane, and land the plane and touchdown. Very good, everyone, wonderful. Whoa, was that fun? And look, we're already at our destination. Oh, how fun. We've made it to our stop, the home of my dear sweet Pop. Dr. Seuss! Oh, he's the one who wrote so many books like Cat in the Hat and some of the ones you were reading today. And here we are in sunny San Diego, where he lived his days out. In fact, that's partially what today is about. Did you know that today is Dr. Seuss's birthday? Oh, he would have been, can you guess how old Dr. Seuss would have been today? Oh, 23 is a little bit too low. Oh, 200's too high. Maybe somewhere in the middle. It would be 118. Oh, well, that's a lot of candles, if you know what I mean. But What better way to celebrate than with a game? Are you ready to play with me? Here we go. We're gonna play a little game that I like to call Kitty Cat Says. Are you ready? We're gonna have everyone stand on up, 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 up. There we go, stretch it out. Things might get wild. First, we're going to teach you how to play. So when you hear the magic words, Kitty Cat Says, you're gonna have to do anything that I say. So if I say Kitty Cat Says, touch your nose, you're gonna touch your nose. Kitty Cat Says, wiggle your ears, you're gonna wiggle your ears. Kitty Cat Says, tap your head. Now, if you don't hear those magic words Kitty Cat Says, you're not going to do it, right? So you only do it if you hear the magic words Kitty Cat Says. Let's give it a try. Kitty Cat Says, fly like a plane in the sky. Kitty Cat Says, give a salute like a captain. Kitty Cat Says, jump up and down. Touch your toes. Oh, did some of you do it? Oh, Kitty Cat didn't say I tricked you. Okay, that's okay. Let's try it again. This one, you're gonna get, I promise. And anyway, it's a good try either way. So here we go. Kitty Cat Says, wiggle your ears. Kitty Cat Says, turn around. Kitty Cat Says, jump up and down. Kitty Cat Says, helicopter while jumping up and down. Kitty Cat Says, jump up and down while helicopter and jumping around in a circle. Kitty Cat Says, stop. Kitty Cat Says, touch your nose. Kitty Cat Says, touch your nose. Kitty Cat Says, touch shoulders. Reach up high. Oh, I didn't say those magic words Kitty Cat Says. That was a good try though. All right, I think we have one more round to go. Here we go. Kitty Cat Says, salute like a captain. Kitty Cat Says, have the plane take off. Whoosh. Fly like Superman. Whoosh. Jump up and down. Oh, I tricked you two times that time. Kitty Cat didn't say. Very good, everyone. Great listening. Great listening. Well, it is a birthday after all, and it would be rude to not show up without a gift, right? So it just so happens that I got something extra special for Dr. Seuss. Do you want to see what it is? Yes? Okay. All right. I wrapped it in this very special bag right here. And it, oh, wait a minute. I forgot. I didn't get him anything this year. Oh, what kind of cat am I? Oh, wait. I know. You can help me again. We can make him a gift. Yes? With all that magic I see in your hearts, whatever we create is sure to be a work of art. Okay, well, we need something. We need a magic word. Words are fantastic. Let's see. I know. My favorite is Truffula Truska. Now that's a mouthful. Can we say Truffula Truska? Let's try one more time. It's hard. Truffula Truska. Very good. And we need all the magic we can get. So grab all the magic out of the air. Grab it, grab it, grab it, grab it, grab all the magic. A little over here, a little over there, and put it in your heart and warm it up. There you go. Think great, toasty, warm, loving thoughts. And we're going to wave all that magic right at this bag. Wave it, wave it, wave it, wave it, wave it. There you go. And on the count of three, we're going to say Truffula Truska. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Truffula Truska. Oh my gosh. Look what you made. Oh, a candle. Oh, that's perfect for making wishes come true. But you know what? He'll already have 118 on his cake, so I don't know if this will do. A little too cliche, if you know what I mean. All right, well, time for attempt number two. Let's say another magic word. I think, Alakazoo. Can we try Alakazoo on the count of three? Ready? 1, 2, 3, Alakazoo! Wow. Oh my gosh, a rainbow of color. We have, what color is that? Pink and orange. And what else? Oh, yellow and green and blue and purple. Oh, it kind of looks like those lights that pilots use to land the plane, or maybe a scarf. No, something's still just not right. This is nice, but I think we can do even better. Let's see. We'll try one last time, yeah? You know what they say? Third time's a charm, so let's not be alarmed. Let's give it, another thought. What's another good magic word? I think I heard someone say, happy birthday! I like that a lot! Here we go. We're going to wave all your magic. Close your eyes. Wish with all your might. We're going to say happy birthday on the count of three. One, two, three. Happy birthday! Oh, I think you did it. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Look at that. Oh, it's just the thing. With this, he can soar to new places like the jungle of Newell or Vipper of Vip or Sawasalu. There's so many places he can go with a plane of his own. Oh, he's really gonna love that. Oh, you are so kind and so generous no matter where you land. Oh no. Oh, what? Oh man, I think it's that time to say goodbye. Oh, thank you, Lyle. Here you go. Oh, all right. Oh, well, never fear. I'm sure we'll meet again someday, either far or near. And I'm so excited to see where life takes you with that brain in your head and those shoes in your feet. Hi, you can steer yourself wherever you please, by car or by train or helicopter or plane. Out there's a big world. And I have no doubt that its mystery you can unfurl.
Thank you so much, Cat in the Hat, for joining us today. I'm sure the kids really enjoyed playing with you. I enjoyed flying our plane, getting the train going, and all of the above. Thank you so much again for joining us this morning. I'm going to let you go and celebrate Dr. Seuss's birthday with him now that you're there. Have a great rest of your day. For all the kids joining, we have one more book to go. We're going to go ahead and bring up our next book, and I'm sure you guys may have heard this book before, maybe have even tried a little something like this before in your classes, but we're going to go ahead and get this one rolling. It's Green Eggs and Ham.
Hi, my name is Carly Casanova, and I am a field training officer at the Los Angeles World Airport Police Department. Today, I'm going to be reading to you Green Eggs and Ham by Dr. Seuss. I am Sam. Sam, I am. That Sam I am, that Sam I am. I do not like that Sam I am. Do you like green eggs and ham? I do not like them, Sam I am. I do not like green eggs and ham. Would you like them here or there? I would not like them here or there. I would not like them anywhere. I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like them, Sam, I am. Would you like them in a house? Would you like them with a mouse? I do not like them in a house. I do not like them with a mouse. I do not like them here or there. I do not like them anywhere. I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like them, Sam, I am. Would you eat them in a box? Would you eat them with a fox? Not in a box, not with a fox, not in a house, not with a mouse. I would not eat them here or there. I would not eat them anywhere. I would not eat green eggs and ham. I do not like them, Sam I am. Would you, could you in a car? Eat them, here they are. I would not in it, could not in a car. You may like them, you will see. You may like them in a tree. I would not, could not in a tree, not in a car, you let me be. I do not like them in a box. I do not like them with a fox. I do not like them in a house. I do not like them with a mouse. I do not like them here or there. I do not like them anywhere. I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like them, Sam I am. A train, a train, a train, a train. Could you, would you on a train? Not on a train, not in a tree, not in a car, Sam, let me be. I would not, could not in a box. I could not, would not with the fox. I will not eat them with the mouse. I will not eat them in a house. I will not eat them here or there. I will not eat them anywhere. I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like them, Sam I am. Say, in the dark, here, in the dark. Would you, could you, in the dark? I would not, could not, in the dark. Would you, could you, in the rain? I would not, could not, in the rain. Not in the dark, not on a train. Not in a car, not in a tree. I do not like them, Sam, you see. Not in a house, not in a box. Not with a mouse, not with a fox. I will not eat them here or there. I do not like them anywhere. You do not like green eggs and ham? I do not like them, Sam, I am. Could you, would you, with a goat? I would not, could not with the goat. Could you on a boat? I would not, could not on a boat. I will not with the goat. I will not eat them in the rain. I will not eat them on the train. Not in the dark, not in the tree, not in the car. You let me be. I do not like them in a box. I do not like them with the fox. I will not eat them in a house. I do not like them with the mouse. I do not like them here or where. I do not like them anywhere. I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like them, Sam I am. You do not like them, so you say. Try them, and you may. Try them, and you may, I say. Sam, if you will let me be, I will try them, you will see. Say, I like green eggs and ham. I do, I like them, Sam I am. And I would eat them in a boat, and I would eat them with the goat. And I will eat them in the rain and in the dark and on the train and in a car and in a tree. They are so good, you see. So I will eat them in a box and I will eat them with the fox and I will eat them in the house and I will eat them with the mouse and I will eat them here and there. Say, I will eat them anywhere. I do so like green eggs and ham. Thank you, Sam I am. Green Eggs and Ham by Dr. Seuss.
I love that book. It just reminds us to always be learning and thinking and trying new things and trying new experiences. And you never know where that next new experience may come from. So we are actually ahead of time and we are about to wrap up the day. But before we wrap up, we have one last poll question. I'm going to let Amy come in and introduce it for us.
Okay, can we bring up that poll question on the screen? All right, so teachers, if you could take a moment and ask your students, what was their favorite book today? So we had three. We had Busy, Busy Airport by Richard Scarry. We had The Cat in the Hat by Dr. Seuss. And we had Green Eggs and Ham by Dr. Seuss as well. So go ahead, teachers. Ask your students, take a poll, and then you can go ahead and enter the response on behalf of your class. And we see the answers coming in, Raina.
I see them rolling in fast. And while these are rolling in, I wanted to let the teachers know that as well as a recording of this will be available on our YouTube page and website, along with an additional book that we weren't able to get in this morning called Un Pez, Dos Peces, Pez Rojo, Pez Azul, which is One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Fish by Dr. Seuss as well. That's going to be available on our YouTube channel. So if you have any Spanish speaking students that want to enjoy another book, we have that available on our YouTube as well. So I'm going to end the poll and share the results.
Wow, I'm surprised. Green Eggs and Ham won out by a landslide. 77% voted for that as their favorite book. Amazing. I love it too.
I do too. It's just, again, thinking about always trying new things and having that exploration in your heart when it comes to reading, literacy, and education. So I want to say thank you guys again this morning for joining us. On behalf of myself and our LAX Community Relations team, I'm going to end this poll. And we're going to let you guys go and have a great rest of your day. Give me a hold.
if you got your funky bus fare. On the bus, pay your fare, then tell the driver that you got went to a double Dutch affair. Eat my food, come, well I'll be darned. Here it comes, the double Dutch bus is on the street. You better get off the move your feet. Bus fare, transpass, that's the way my money lasts. Ain't got no car to get around. When I go to work, I gotta go downtown. Now I miss my train, that's a common shame. When I'm running late, no streets to blame. If you got a wife, you know I'm right. You got a special man, well I can understand. Everybody's getting down. Say uptown, say downtown. Well, I miss my bus. I know I'm late. I gotta do something I know I hate. I'm gonna walk to work. 15 bucks. I already got my hole in the socks. Go ahead and laugh. That's okay, of course. What I really wanna say, I got bad feet. My coins hurt. Top it off. I'm late for work. Let me tell you what I say.